Have you ever had that problem where there's like you use some hardware and it just doesn't quite sound right, slightly off? You can't figure out what it is? Well, if you're a Pro Tools user, it's probably delay compensation. So today we're going to look at timing your hardware round trip latency to make sure that all the outboard gear that you're using lines up bang on with the delay compensation. I know that when I started out, I just used to whack hardware on there and then wonder why everything sounded weird or slightly delayed, or sometimes you can even get as much as like a slapback sound. It depends on the round trip latency of your conversion, but I'm going to show you how to do this to make sure that everything that you have is bang on, perfect. So let's jump into Pro Tools and let me show you how it works. All right, so we're in Pro Tools, and here's what you want to do. What you want to do is get yourself something very transient heavy, a snare, a click, anything like that. And I always just put like four of them. You want your sample that you're going to use on your first track, along with the piece of outboard gear as a hardware insert. Now, the important thing to remember is that the piece of hardware gear is in bypass, because all you want to do is get the round trip latency through that gear and back into the converter. So you don't want any time-based effects or anything like that. So delays, reverbs, all that thing, stick them in bypass or turn the mix all the way down. I'm using a Pro VLA compressor, easy enough. I don't want the compression to, smear the transient or anything like that. So I'm going to put the compressor in bypass so that I can travel through the unit and back into the antelope to get an exact round trip latency time. Your second audio track, this is going to be the one that you record back to. So you want to send your first track out of a bus, and the same bus is the input for the second track. Now let's record this back. So we're going from the sample through the Pro VLA out of this track into this track. So that's a round trip through the converters. And let's see if we've got a delay. So if we zoom in all the way, oh yes, we have got a delay. As you can see, this delay here, the way one unit is shifted behind the other, that is your round trip latency. Now, here's how you work it out. You want to get the very first point on here where the audio passes the zero crossing, the very first part of the transient, which is, let's say, somewhere there. Yeah, somewhere there. And then we select back to the bar. Now, if we change up here on the left, we've got it on bars and beats, you'll then need to select samples. And that gives us 18 samples. So here's how you figure this out. Open up your calculator, and you want to go 18 divided by the sample rate you're working in, which for me would be 48, which is 0.375. So you could go either way, 37 or 38. We're going to have to kind of figure that out. Now, having done this timing before, I know what the actual figure is, but I'll show you how I got there. We go into the setup menu and I/O. And as you can see, the actual figure is 0.39, but let me show you. So it's 0.375, right? So let's go down 0.37. Let's round down. We'll stick 0.37 in there. Now let's do the test again. Hit play. Let's see how close we are this time. We're closer, but we're not quite perfect. We're definitely not quite perfect. Set it back to bars and beats. As you can see, here is still a way off from here. So if we measure this again, let's say from this peak, to the start of this peak, roughly. We're going roughly in the middle point of the peak. Back to samples. That gives us 2. Now I think it might be slightly less than 2. I think you're potentially looking at 1. Well, our first figure was 18, so let's try 19 divided by 48. And that gives you 0.39. Now, the eagle-eyed viewers among you may have noticed this figure before. 0.39, which is what I already had. Now I'm going to show you 0.39. Let's go again. And now if we zoom out, and we zoom back in, that is pretty bang on. That's pretty bang on. And there you go. That is how you work out delay compensation. 0.39, and if you zoom out to the wider waveform, that looks pretty similar to me. Now, there is a caveat. Let me show you the next piece of gear. The next piece of gear I'm going to time is the Echo Pro. Now again, let me check. The Echo Pro is in bypass. But why would the Echo Pro be different? Well, let's track it. And you'll see that this one, the delay on this one is absolutely gross. It's miles away. Much further than the Pro VLA was. Now why is that? This is something you need to be aware of. In digital gear, not only have you got the round trip latency through the converter, but you also have the internal A to D and D to A conversion. Now the Echo Pro is digital inside, it has its own AD converters. So that's going to add additional latency. The same goes for things like reverbs and things like that. Anything that's digital on the inside is going to have a larger delay, so you're going to have to time them on separately. Compressors, EQs, anything that's 100% analog, that same 0.39 figure will work for all of them, because as we know, analog audio has no delay, it's instant. So let's do the same calculation again. We don't want samples, we want slap bars and beats again, and let's get the bit where it leaves about there and stick it back in samples, and that gives us 83 samples. 83 divided by 48 is, let's call it one, that next number wrong is 9, so let's call it 1.73. Yeah, shocking, 1.73, wow. And this is on 15 and 16, so 1.73. Let's try this again. Zoom out, back in. It's still not quite right. And we had a very similar thing last time. Now last time we had to add on, was it 2 to that number? And again, it's another sample. And we added 1 sample on last time. So, let's times that by 48 to get back to our original number. So this time, let's go 84. 1.75. That's a nice, easy number. Let's go 1.75. Let's try again. And bam, there we go. That looks nigh on identical to me. So as you can see, that piece of gear with its own digital conversion adds significantly more latency. So what you want to do is map out which of your gear is analog, which of your gear is digital, time them all, so as you can see, 0.39 across the board until we get to the Echo Pro, which is 1.75, and then further down the line we go to 0.66. That's because the second antelope that I've got is over a MADI cable, and so we're going from Pro Tools into the first antelope, down the MADI cable, out of the second antelope through the gear and back. So essentially the round trip is almost doubled. But once you've got all your figures in everything, then you can put any piece of hardware on as a hardware insert and it'll be absolutely fine. Now unfortunately it does change the figure when you're working on different sample rates, so if you're working in 44.1 you're going to have to retime everything, and then when you work back to 48 you're going to have to retime everything. So if you switch between the two quite often, I would keep a spreadsheet or a little file somewhere just with your figures in, so you know what they are, make life a bit easier. That being said, if you only work with bus, mixed bus, let's say, hardware bit, so maybe you have a bus compressor or an SSL fusion or something like that, and your entire mix is going through it, you don't have to bother timing at all because the delay doesn't matter. If your entire mix is going through something, if it returns slightly later before you hear it, that's not the end of the world. Where it's applicable is if you're using hardware inserts within a mix. So, for instance, if you have two snare samples, the same sample, and you treat one differently, say you're really distorting one of them or you're compressing another one, and they're returning to Pro Tools at different times, you can end up with phase cancellation and all types of wacky things happen. I noticed with the delay when I timed it wrong the first time round, it caused weird phase issues because the time it took for the actual repeats to start coming was almost bang on like phase cancelling. It was horrific. You can get a load of weird effects, but basically, yeah, you need to time your stuff if you're using hardware inserts. I hope this video is useful to some of you out there who might be struggling with this. I know I did at first, and even when I figured out that you could time the delay, I still got it wrong. So maths is not my strong suit, but anyway, hopefully you found this useful and this can help you out and lead to less hair pulling. Thanks a lot for joining me today, and until we meet again, be well.